Come stop your crying, it will be all right. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will protect you from all around you. I will be here.
We've been doing this for 10 years. We work for Cedars-Sinai Transplant Program. And so we experience this every day. We'd just like to thank them for honoring their mother's wishes and believing in her choice to be an organ donor.
The selflessness of their family and of Troy is going to prevent tragedy and bring a long, healthy, happy life to others, and they'll experience a blessing because of that.
There are other people's lives have been saved and enriched by the love and the generosity showed by this family, and I can't even imagine. I really can't imagine if we lost one of ours. To be able to even consider other people in that time of grief is really amazing.
It's a great honor. That's why, I mean, this is my second year, and I'm sure I'll continue to do it every year, to be able to honor people that have donated their organs to, you know, to help people be able to survive or live.
A little bit about her. She was diagnosed, I believe, with epilepsy from the time she was 8. It's kind of ironic that I got this particular person, because my brother was diagnosed with epilepsy when he was real young. I guess that makes it kind of close to home for me.
We would like to thank them for their donation and thank them for having the courage to do this. I'm sure it was a very difficult decision, but because of that donation, other lives have been affected positively.
Every time we come here, this is my third year, this is her fourth year. We love doing this for the families, and it makes us feel just really good, and hopefully it just is wonders for the families too, to know that they're going to be on the float in the Rose Parade in 2012.
I'm a living kidney donor for my brother 5 years in 2013. It's just an honor. It's an honor. It's the least that I can do for those who have given the gift of life as well, and to meet new people, new friends, and it's a great pleasure.
When we read the story about him, it was incredible that he did so much.
We'd just like to say thank you for allowing us to be able to do this. It's an honor and a privilege.
I have been involved with Donate Life California for a year and a half now, serving as CEO of the organization. It's nice for me to experience donation from this side and be able to give something back to his family who gave so others could live.
We have seen how many lives really get touched by organ donation. And it's not just one person that's helping. And like same with Jesse, it was not 7.
It's a community. It's all her classmates.
Yeah, and it keeps going even through things like this.
Well, I'm a transplant coordinator at UCI, Kidney Transplant Program. And so it's very rewarding to be able to do this for a family, because they have given so much for us.
Every person that is personified in a Floragraph is definitely a hero.
Yes.
And it's an honor to be doing this for the family.
Yeah.
We hope we're doing them justice.
My daughter passed away 2 years ago, and she's 21. And I guess because of the death of my daughter and what she gave, I understand what the family is going through. And my empathy to them and for their courage for donation, because it's not necessarily an easy choice, but I give lots of credit to them.
Well, this is a lovely honor, a tribute to the families and the donor, to be able to commemorate them in a way that captures what we hope is the essence of the person in the photograph.
My brother David Rodriguez was a donor, and he passed away in 2002. So that brings us here to also do photographs of other family members that cannot come over here.
My son is an organ donor. We donated all 8 organs. So we've been here like 4 years already, so it's an honor to come back and do it over and over again.
It just has a big meaning towards us because our brother was a donor. We like to meet new families. I love seeing their faces when we meet them at the breakfast. It's just a big thing for me, big impact on my life.
This affects me personally because
I've had two donors, and one of my donors is also a teenager. It's a real honor to get to know what Delaney was all about and how much we know that she meant to her folks and her siblings.
We're just so honored to be able to have a small part of getting to know who she is. And she's just a beautiful girl, and you can tell by her eyes. Just to me, it just shows a love of life and a passion for giving in others. She's such a beautiful girl.
It made me think a lot about, I was always skeptical about putting that donor tab on my license, but after this, I got it in my back pocket. I'm going to go online, and I think I'm going to do it.
It must be very rewarding knowing that you had a child so loving and so giving, and she continues to give, and she's so much alive in everyone's lives right now.
It means quite a bit to me and my family because of the selfishness of other people. I received a kidney transplant almost 2 years ago, and somebody like this did something special to give me another chance at life, so I appreciate it and respect it and very, very much.
Landon was 17 when he passed away. He saved 57 people by donating his organs. So I just want to say to the family, it's an honor being here, and we'll see you at the luncheon.
It's really special for me because Ryan is only a week younger than I am. So that's kind of like, it makes me emotional because he's the same age as me, and it's really, I don't know, it's really special for me to be able to do that for his family.
The past 5 years, I have been working with Donate Life and filming for them and interviewing families that have been in the same position as the Storch family. Wanted to volunteer our time to bring to life Taylor in a Floragraph. And she's beautiful, and I think the picture will come to life when we finally decorate her eyes.
This time of year, it's really important that we think back and remember Quinn, remember the gift that he gave, and just honor him. So that's really important to us.
I received a kidney from my cousin almost 13 years ago. So I've been doing this since 2007. And it's just an honor to meet everybody, and we just enjoy it. We get to meet so many people.
This being our first time, we are very honored here to be participating in helping the family in order to have some sort of memory of Andrea on the float, and we are honored, and the only thing we want to do is make this special and perfect.
I'm a liver transplant recipient. Both of us are ambassadors of Donate Life. This little fella here is Ryan Lee Webster. He's from Waco, Texas. Him and his father made a promise to each other, a pinky promise, that if something happened, they would each make sure the other donated to try to save lives. And unfortunately, it came down to that.
My connection to donation is that I'm a kidney transplant recipient. I received a kidney from my sister, Tracy, 26 years ago. So I've been very fortunate. And Thomas was a wonderful young man. He was able to save 6 lives with his organ donation. So we're very honored today to decorate this Floragraph.
Our son was on the Floragraph, or had a Floragraph last year. And so we came to decorate his Floragraph last year. This year we volunteered to do it for another family. And so we're really honored to be able to do this for them.
I'm a kidney transplant recipient of 7 years from a deceased donor. So it's just an honor to do these for people that can't make it here.
Because we're so grateful for the gift that John received, and it's our way to be able to say thank you.
He was a very remarkable 17-year-old young man who died in a traffic accident. This is very emotional for me because my life was saved by a 17-year-old girl who also died in a traffic accident.
I'm just very honored to be able to do this today because of everything he went through.
He gave his corneas. He helped someone be able to see. And being a recipient myself, it makes me understand what that gift of life truly means. So I can only imagine what whoever received his eyes, to know that now they're able to see and appreciate life and see what's going around them.
I'm really enjoying getting to know Shelby. Whenever I've done this, and I've done this, it's the fourth Floragraph that I've been able to do. It seems like we get to know the person. Their essence comes right out, and
becomes a part of who we are, and that's really quite a blessing.
It is very, very important to give the gift of life to people, and we see that you've done with your son. He's a wonderful person, as from what I heard and read about him. And I just want to thank you for the opportunity, and I hope we get the time to meet at the lunch, at the brunch.
To think that there's other people living because of this young man and of all of these people that have donated organs. You know, I find it very, very difficult to explain. There's so much going on, and this just really touches you.
It's an honor to decorate her picture. It's a experience. She donated five of her organs, and it was July 4th of 2009.
And I'm hoping that her family will take a lot of contentment and joy in having this young lady on the float, because she's a great representation of what we all stand for.
Well, for me personally, it was an honor to come and do this. I think it's very personal to actually see the person who donated, and this is very a very personal way of coming together with other families that do the same thing.
From getting to know him through his bio and just looking at his picture for all these hours, you could just tell how heartwarming he is, you know, what a great personality he had.
This is our second year doing the Floragraph. We did this last year for my nephew. He was honored with a Floragraph on the float last year. So we were asked to volunteer this year for those parents and family members that couldn't come. And she's making sure that she does a good job, because this is going to be something that the family's going to have to cherish and have it, you know, displayed in their home.
I know what you guys are going through. I've been there myself. And for the same reason, I want your son's Floragraph to be the most beautiful one on the Rose Parade float this year.
I think this one touches my heart more. I don't know why. Just I see him, and to know that his wife had a baby without him knowing, you know, it's just very touching to me. And for her to go through that at such a young age and end up with two beautiful kids to remind her of the life she had with her husband, just very touching to me.
Each story is different, but the underlying thing is that this is just so great. And we just feel like we get to know the people more as we decorate it and see his face over and over. And throughout the years that we've done this, we still remember every single person that we've done, and we won't forget it.